Let's say we are the company that would like to internationalize. Within the marketing, you are going to see several very interesting models about how you should do that. I personally would recommend Born Global's topic. Okay, but in this video, we are going to talk about the companies that internationalize according to Uppsala model. So here is our study case. We are a small manufacturing company. At first, we decide to expand to country that is very close to us, especially there is similar language and also similar political system. Secondly, we will go overseas, but we will choose especially one country because there is similar culture and the same currency that is used as in our origin country. Our company internationalized exactly according to our Uppsala model, and here is going to be why. We consider something called experiential knowledge. And maybe you know my habits of always focusing on the word itself, so I would rewrite it as the knowledge of experience. And now it makes more sense. So the model says we should be very aware of the experience we encountered from our past performance. So thanks to understanding of this experience, our products or organization is going to be better in this newly entered market. It will make more sense when I introduce you the second term, and that is the consideration of psychic distance. This is quite special kind of distance because it takes into account information that can disturb or prevent the flow of information. So now when we get back to our study case, we see why we have chosen at first the country with similar language and economic system, because these are the most influential factors considering the psychic distance. Secondly, we have moved to country with similar culture and currency. These are a bit weaker factors, but they still can influence, for instance, our divisional reports or financial reports. Well, let's write down the exact steps we should do according to Uppsala model. At the very first, we should have no regular export activities, so that we are mostly just in our domestic country. Secondly, we should try to do some international sales through some sales representatives, so that our headquarters works very fine in domestic country and we just send some guys abroad that try to sell and promote the products. Thirdly, we create so-called sales subsidiaries. This is a bit tricky, but I will write on move to fourth step so you will see the difference. Just at fourth step, we have some manufacturing subsidiaries. Just at this point, we move our manufacturing outside, so until now, we were still manufacturing just in our origin country. What is important to remember that according to Uppsala model, we should proceed to every next step just when we successfully complete the actual one. So it's really step-by-step method. Well, and for the conclusion, what would be my personal comment to this is that this model was developed long time ago in some 1970s and 1980s according to companies that were successful that time. Now it is a bit outdated. Secondly, if you intuitively imagine this step-by-step method, it cannot really exist. All the companies would follow exactly the same strategy and individuals would have no choice, so that everyone would consider the same psychic distance factors and experiential knowledge, and individuals would follow exactly the same strategies. So this was Uppsala model for internationalizing.